welcome you to our worship service on this holiest of nights. The light of the world, Jesus, is coming into our midst. Let's stand as we share together the hymn printed in your bulletin, O Come, All Ye Faithful.
Tonight, we celebrate hope fulfilled in the birth of Christ Jesus. Joy to the world, Emmanuel has come. We celebrate the promise of peace and joy and love.
May we all look at ourselves and prepare a new room in our lives.
Tonight, we light the Christ candle and pray that his promises will live in our hearts and in our world. Everything we have been waiting for has arrived. Let us praise God for his blessed gift on this holy night.
For you have offered to us a gift straight from your heart. The light that pierces the darkness has come among us. We pray tonight that during this time of worship, O Lord, that you would attune our hearts and minds to hear, to receive, and to respond, that we might live in the light of the Christ child each day. It's in his name we gather, and in his name we pray. Amen. Thank you. You may be seated.
Hear now the words of the prophet Micah. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, you are one of the little clans of Judah. From you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth. Hear now the words of the Gospel of Matthew. Now the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to the public disgrace, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save the people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. "Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel," which means God with us. When Joseph awoke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took her as his wife, but had no marital relations with her until she had borne a son, and he named him Jesus.
Thank you. Hear these words from John's Gospel. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
In this season in which God has offered to us the greatest gift of all, we have the opportunity as a congregation to extend ourselves beyond these walls through the worship of God in giving. Know that your Christmas offering this evening continues to support our missionaries and mission projects, our mission endeavors and ministry endeavors, both locally and globally. We have the opportunity to extend the light of the world, Jesus, out into the world today. We invite the ushers to come at this time. We'll receive the Lord's tithes and our offerings as we hear together, He is born. brings joy to our hearts. We have such reason to rejoice this evening in all that God has done for us. Every year our youth go Christmas caroling to our homebound, and as you go around caroling, the two songs that all the folks want us to sing are always Joy to the World and Silent Night, because those sort of capture, I think, the true spirit of Christmas for so many people. Let's stand together as we sing the carol, Joy to the World. Bow with me in prayer. Lord, we thank you for the opportunity of sharing in the work that you're doing in our world. We pray tonight that you would bless the gifts that we've offered. We pray that you would use them to magnify the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and spread his good news in word and deed to all people. Through Christ our Lord, we pray. Amen. Thank you. You may be seated.
In that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was the angel with a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. Let us stand together and sing "Hark the Herald Angels Sing," found in your bulletin.
Eric, you may be seated. You know, in the world of texting and Instagram and Snapchat and all kinds of different messaging platforms that are out there now, as soon as they started, a whole new language emerged. And that language continues to emerge as the platforms expand. From the very basic TTYL and LOL and all of those that we learned as these platforms became popular. One of those that became popular one time was F2F, meaning face-to-face. Sending you a little message or a snap or so forth is not enough. We need to talk about this or share about this. F2F, we need to share face-to-face. I think that's what really describes well the scriptures leading up to the New Testament and the birth of Jesus Christ. That's kind of what God did with humanity to get his message to us. He tried just words. He sent us the law, the Ten Commandments. He tried voice. He sent us the prophets to proclaim his word. And finally, I think God must have decided the only way to get through and reach us imperfect, hard-headed, hard-hearted humans was to request, to initiate an F2F, a face-to-face encounter. And friends, on this holy night, through the birth of the Christ child into our world, you are invited by the Lord himself to a face-to-face encounter with the mighty God. We have beheld his glory, the Gospel of John says, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father. God invites you to that kind of personal experience face-to-face. First, God invites us to a face-to-face encounter with a new person. A new person. This child, Jesus, can change who you are. This child, Jesus, can change how you live. I never forget a number of years ago when a friend of mine had his first child. And he said to me what many people have said. Never in a million years, when I looked into the face of that little baby, did I know that my life would completely change. Friends, maybe you don't know, but I hope that you do. As soon as you look at Jesus Christ, as soon as you look at the gift that God has given, your life can change. Your life can be different. You can discover one who will be with you regardless of the circumstances and situations of your life. And not only will you come face to face with a new person God has revealed in Jesus Christ, but you'll come face to face with a new person because you will discover your own identity. You will discover who you were intended to be. It's not just about finding out who God is through Jesus Christ. That's first. But then through him, I discover who I am. I find that God has revealed my identity by sending his son, Jesus Christ. Let me say it this way. Nell Mooney, she tells the story of how her father, her earthly father, set her free to live. She said when she was in middle school, she really started rebelling, mainly because she envied her older sister. Her older sister was perfect at everything, she said. She played her instrument perfectly. She got the best grades in school. Everything about her was perfect. So Nell decided that what I'd do was just do the opposite. I would just rebel. And finally, she said her father asked her about this. Nell, what really's bothering you? And she said, I'll never be like my sister. I'll never be good enough. And she said, her dad said, let's take a walk. And she said that was the walk that changed her life. Because this is what he told her. Nell, God put a treasure inside of you. It's different from any treasure that anyone else has. It's not like your sisters. It's not like your brothers. And your mother and I simply want to help you discover your treasure. Nell Mooney says that set me free to be the person that God intended me to be. Friends, that's the face-to-face encounter with a new person that God invites you toward today. God has placed a treasure within you, every single one of you. And it's different for every person. But one thing's for sure. When we open our lives to the one who was born in Bethlehem, God will reveal that treasure to you over time. You will discover who you are intended to be. You will come face to face with a new person. The new person will be looking out the mirror at you, back at you, as God shows you who you are intended to be. I pray tonight, wherever you are in life, whatever circumstances you may be facing, that you will discover that new person by having a face-to-face encounter with the Savior of the world, Jesus Christ. Secondly, God invites us to a face-to-face encounter with a new presence. A new presence. The promise that God made in the Old Testament thousands of years ago is fulfilled. Did you hear it in Matthew's gospel as it was read? His name shall be called Emmanuel, which means God is with us. The God who is present in all things and through all things, the God who has been the God of generations past and will be for generations to come. He's the God that the psalmist says, "Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil. Why? For thou art with me." He's the God that said to Joshua, "Joshua, don't be afraid. I will be with you wherever you go." And he's the God that said in Jesus Christ, "I will be with you always, even to the very end." Friends, this is the new presence that God wants to bring to bear on your life. It's time that all of us open ourselves again to that presence. Bob and Lisa McKenna, they have a special needs child named Josh. Bob McKenna says that their tradition of their family, everyone decorates their homes and their lawns differently. But he said, every year we put a manger scene there in our yard, and we have two big spotlights, and we've seen them around our town as well, have two big spotlights that shine on the manger scene. And he said, we turn those on when it gets dark, and then come morning we'll turn them off. But he says, our son Josh, he can't wait. He can't wait till the darkness comes, because he's the one that gets to turn on the spotlights. So he says, every Christmas, during the Christmas season, after we put the manger out, almost every evening, it's Josh coming in and saying, "Is it time?" "No, no, no, honey, not yet. It's still a couple more hours yet till dark." "Is it time? Is it time?" He can't wait. He's anticipating it so much, he can't wait to turn on the light and spot the manger. Is it time? I say to you this evening, it is time. It is time for you to experience the light of the world, Jesus Christ, that can come into any darkness that you are facing in your life today. It is time for you to know that whether it's you or a family member or a colleague or a classmate, that whatever they may be facing, and however high the anxiety level may be, and however may uncertain the future may seem, and however great the fear may be in your heart, that there is a new presence who has arrived this evening, and his name is Emmanuel, God with us. It is time for you and I to know this truth and to experience that presence deep within our hearts so that we can be strengthened regardless of what we may be facing in life. You know someone. I know someone that needs that presence. Unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. Emmanuel, the solid sign that God is with us. I pray that you will have a face-to-face encounter with this new presence available to all of us this evening. Finally, God invites us to a face-to-face encounter with a new purpose. A new purpose. Sometimes it takes us a while, but finally we realize that the purpose for us being here, we can ask the question, what in the world am I doing here? What does God have in mind? Does God have a dream or a plan for who I am supposed to be and how I am supposed to live and what I am supposed to do? And the answer is yes. And you say, how do we discover that purpose? How do we discover that true core purpose of who we are? And friends, we discover it at Bethlehem. We discover it through the Christ child. We can come face to face with our purpose in living. They announced peace on earth, goodwill to all. Rejoice. Experience the glory of God. Friends, our purpose as followers of Jesus Christ is not just to observe the light that has come into the world, but to take that light into a darkened world. And as we worship at 11 o'clock on Christmas Eve at Bridgeport United Methodist Church, we know that there's darkness in our world. We know that there's chaos in our world. We know that there's division in our world. We know that there's hatred in our world. We can ignore it, we can bury our heads in the sand, or we can accept our purpose as followers of the Christ child to take his light into that world of injustice and hatred and prejudice and be the light that we see in Jesus Christ. Another parish that I served, it was some years ago, it was my first Christmas Eve service with the congregation. Very nice crowd. I found out later on there was a little history there, but I'll tell you now. But as we went to light our candles, I heard a little voice from the back say, "Not this time." So out of place. "Not this time." Well, I had no idea what was going on. We continued to light it. Well, afterwards, the mother of the young boy apologized. And she said, "Well, you see, the past 2 years, Wayne's little brother, whenever we would pass the light, after he lit his candle, he would lean over and blow his brother's candle out." And he said, "2 weeks ago, we had my son's birthday party, and we had some of those candles that you blow out and then they relight. And he said he stuck one of those in his pocket and he brought it to the candle lighting service." And so what you heard was, whenever they lit his candle, sure enough, his little brother leaned over and so you heard him say, "Not this time. Not this time." And his candle relit. And to the astonishment of his little brother, remained lit for the rest of the candle lighting service. Friends, in our world today, and in your life sometimes, hate will try to get the upper hand. Not this time. In your world, in our world, chaos will try to have the final word. Listen, friends, not this time. In the world in which we live today, division will try to tell you that's the only way. As followers of the Christ child, we need to be saying, "Not this time." There will be times in your life and in our lives together when grief will try to have the upper hand in your life. The light of the world, Jesus, is with you, so not this time. And there will come a day when someone you love, or perhaps you yourself, stand on the threshold of the grave, and you'll see the valley that's called the shadow of the death, and that valley will try to tell you, "This is the end." And the light of the world, Jesus, says, "Not this time. Not this time." Friends, God invites us to come face to face with the purpose that we have to share the good news of Jesus Christ with all people. I pray tonight that you will encounter again the Christ child, the Christmas message, the good news of great joy that shall be to all people. Encounter it face to face, and then decide to live for him daily. Let us pray. Indeed, O God, you have revealed all of your love, the fullness of your glory, your desire for peace and hope and joy. You've revealed it all tonight in your Son, Jesus Christ. May we never prefer the darkness, and may we never give darkness more credit than it deserves. May we allow your light to fill our hearts, to fill our lives, to guide and direct our living each day. It is in the name of the Christ child that we pray. Amen. Light of the world, Jesus has come. We'll have the opportunity now to not only receive the light, but to share the light with one another. As the light is shared with you, share it to those who are next to you. We'll begin with an opening verse played on the harp, and then we will begin to sing Silent Night. Let us stand as we receive and share the light with one another. light of the world has arrived. It is the light that pierces all darkness. This light will guide your path. Let us go forth and share his light with all. In his name we depart to serve. Amen.